بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى اما بعد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في الكلام المجيد والفرقان الحميد بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم افضل الذكر لا اله الا الله صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى ال سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم صلى الله My most honorable brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today I'm going to talk about the majlis number 3 of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullahi alayhi. Some advice from there. Please listen very carefully. Great, great Sheikh, Wali Allah, Sheikh Shai Awli Akram. Advice, we should not try to become ghani. We should not have desire to become very rich. Because Allah knows, He should give you much richness, much money. Maybe He don't give you. Make you too much rich. He knows. May your richness may become the source of your destruction. So we should be contented what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. And the same way he's talking about, if we are sick, we should make dua. Ya Allah, give me relief. Remove my sickness. But we should not complain. We should not ask Allah SWT, you must give me relief. Give me shifa. Ya Allah, you have to give me shifa. Please give me shifa. Not like that. We can ask shifa, but we cannot have this telling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like a commanding kind of thing. We shall beg from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shifa from the marz. Because He knows how long your sickness will be. Because He may want to give you, forgive the sins. According to a rawayat hadith paak, when a person gets sick, his sins are forgiven. Allah is giving you sickness to forgive your sin and take you to Jannah right away without going to Jahannam to clean up the sins. But again, we should beg Allah SWT, Ya Allah, give me shifa. And also, we go to the doctor also. And we should be content that whatever Allah SWT has blessed us in the dunya, we should be contented. Otherwise, a person is not contented, he is greedy. He may leave the deen to collect more and more and more. What should we ask? Ya Allah, forgive my crimes. Forgive my sins. Small or big, Saghira and Kabira, and bless me with the easiness and comfort is in dunya as well as is in the akhirat. Those are the people only have correct high level of tawheed, high level of yaqeen, high level of iman, who are patient in the musibah, in the trial, in tribulation, they are patient. And for the blessing, what they enjoy, they do shukr on those blessings. So condition should be either in the shukr or in the sabr. It has been reported by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when you get the knowledge, which is a must, we should get knowledge. Fariza ala kulli muslimin wa muslimatin, fariza on men and women to get knowledge. But once we have got knowledge, then knowledge cries for the amal. If there's no amal, no action after the knowledge, according to the knowledge, there is no action, then ilm, knowledge, don't stay there. It go away. Means what? The person lose the blessing of the knowledge. Therefore, we are supposed to get knowledge. What we get knowledge, we should put into practice. Because the essence of the knowledge, the maghz of the knowledge, the essence of the knowledge is action. Because the ilm knowledge is a prerequisite of action. That's why the very first wahi which came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was about what? Not about action. About knowledge. Iqra. Iqra. Read. 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 And then the action. Ya ayyuhal mudassir, kum fa anzir. Stand up and invite the people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then action came. And remember that the zakat of the ilm is action, amal. If we don't pay the zakat, then what will happen to our money, property, our ornament? A woman does not pay the zakat of the ornament, she will lose. Maybe her ornament are stolen. Same way, if we don't pay the zakat of the knowledge, which is action, that we may lose, forget the knowledge. The best way to keep knowledge in the mind, best way to remember something, put into action. You will never forget it. If you don't want to forget anything, put into action. Moreover, we advise there we should earn our livelihood with any profession or trade or labor. We should not earn our living through the deen. If the people earn through the deen and give the wrong answer of the question, wrong fatwa, and make some money, that's haram. A true alim will earn by his own hand something. It's very, very important. Unless he is so busy in some madrasa or some masjid where he's spreading the deen, and then the masajid people will take care of his need. That's okay. But he should not only depend on the people for his living. If he's independent, if alim is independent, then he has more honor and he will be very freely give his judgment in the deen without any fear. We are inherited, ulama are inherited of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They command good and forbid the people from the evil. We should do tawbah. We should do repentance. We should get the knowledge. We should put knowledge into action. With and also, we should get the acquire the quality of the ikhlas and the sincerity. True tawbah repentance, true knowledge of deen, true action, and true ikhlas. This we needed for the true guidance. Without these, we cannot get true guidance. We may be led astray by shaitan and our nafs, our desire, are the bad company. In the day of Qiyamah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell, command to the Jahannam, be cool. You know that everybody had to cross Jahannam by a bridge of Sirat. Everybody had to cross Jahannam, down the river of Jahannam, up their bridge. 500 up, 500 years down. Everybody had to cross. Some will cross by speed of lightning. That way. But then, any person who is very honest, with iman, strong faith, in la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, and he is very sincere, and he put into action what he learned, Allah SWT will command to the Jahannam, be cool. My servant, with the knowledge, with the action, and true faith, are crossing now. Be cool. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enlist us among these people. Ameen. Is it possible? When we are alive, we should try to get the knowledge of deen and put into practice. And it should be sweetened with ikhlas. But without ikhlas, nothing will be accepted. Period. And the most wisest person is that who connect himself 24 hour every minute second with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the master and creator. Any need, any problem, he should look to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, back from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He should not go to any other door. That is a shirk. For example, if wife needs something and she is asking to a friend of the husband, tell me how husband will feel. Husband is there. And she asking husband friend, her husband brother, give me $5. How hospitable feel? Very bad. Well, husband has everything. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of everything. Every time he is available and he likes also. He also say iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Only back from me. Then how husband will be angry? He may say, get out of here. We go with him. Stay away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not tolerate if we go to any other door in the need other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah loves it. Well, small baby asks mommy, give me. Mommy, give him. Child always asks mommy. They never say anything else. The same way we should be with Allah like a mommy. More than that, a mommy always answers the child. Always. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves us more than 70 mother. Subhanallah. Allah Akbar. Be very, very careful. We should not be like that person. In the business of the dunya, we should not be like that person. We should not do any business in the darkness without ilm. If we do any business in the darkness, we may suffer like a person who go to collect the woods in the jungle in the night time to bring the wood to burn the fire for cooking. He goes in the night time. In the night time, he may catch snake. It is very cold weather. A snake has become like frozen and look like also snake look like a branch of wood. And he pick a snake, bring home. So he become warm, he bite up. So we should not do any business, any action with darkness, without ilm. We should get the light of the ilm. And when then under the light of ilm, ilm of what? Ilm of tawheed. Ilm of sharia. Along with the taqwa. We should do our business. We should lead our life under the light of the sunshine. Sunshine light of taqwa, tawheed, and sharia. We should do our business under this light. Then, inshallah, we will be successful in our business. And if we do business in the darkness, we may be beaten up by the snake or big damage, big loss. And we know that this light will keep you aware of our enemies, our desire, our nafs, shaitan, and shirk. So we should be aware of our enemies and our personal bad habits. These are our enemies. Devil, our nafs, uncontrolled wordless, uncontrolled desire. Devil, personal bad habits, and our bad company. We have to beware of these enemies. And on the right hand, we should have tawheed la ilaha illallah, full yaqeen in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the left hand, we shall sharia Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in the heart, we should have taqwa, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then inshallah, we will be successful. We will remain successful in this dunya and the akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with a strong faith, a strong action, a strong ikhlas and sincerity. Wa akhiru da'wana anil alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzat amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ameen, ameen. Let's make dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give shifa to all sick people who are in coronavirus or any other sickness. Please make special dua for my daughter, my son-in-law, my grandson, my granddaughter. Make special dua. May Allah bless shifa to all sick people, and may Allah save all of us from this unbelievable disease. We should do lot of istighfar. Because of our sins, we should do lot of istighfar. I may recommend after every salah should be 100 times. We should do lot of sadqa. So that Allah save us. And let's make dua. Allahumma inna نعوذ بك من البرس والجنون والجزام ومن سيء الأسقام اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من البرس والجنون والجزام ومن سيء الأسقام اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من البرس والجنون والجزام فمن السيئات قام اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وواقنا عذاب النار واقنا عذاب القبر واقنا عذاب الحشر واقنا عذاب الميزان وصلى الله تعالى على حبيبه سيدنا محمد وعلى وصحبه اجمعين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته ان شاء الله we see you again on coming Sunday